Hello everyone! Today I have a little announcement for you, and I've just completed a new post-processing tutorial, which is now available on my homepage. And other than the last tutorials, it's no complete start to finish tutorial. I rather focus on solely the creative part of my processing for a photo I did. And yet, to give you a little overview of what this tutorial is about, I'll now show you the introduction video of the tutorial. Also, on my homepage, if you're heading there, you'll find a discount code which is active, and you can use it on any of my tutorials. So using this code, which you see at the top of the page, you get 25% off any purchase you do. So yeah, enough said now. Let's head over to the introduction so you get an overview of what the new tutorial is about and if it's interesting for you. This tutorial is all about creating dark and moody images. I show you my complete creative workflow for this photo here, which I photographed last autumn. You'll learn the creative adjustments I do to this photo, adding contrast, color contrasts, and you'll also learn how I added fog into the scene, because actually the raw photo didn't contain any fog. And I show you an approach how you can create realistic fog in an image. If we want to create a moody atmosphere for a photo in post-processing by darkening the image, by adding atmosphere or fog, so diffusing some details in the background, simplifying the scene, it helps to first look at a photo which was taken with such conditions. So a photo with real fog, for example, can help us understand how we have to work on a photo in post-processing to create a convincing result. For this, we're gonna look at a photo which I shot 2 years ago in a German forest where there was thick fog, and it was really a magical scene, and I also recorded a vlog for it, which you can watch on my YouTube channel. But this here is the final photo, which you can already see is being processed. So let's look at the base, which is the original file. And even with this file, you see that the fog, it shrouds the trees in the distance into a layer of white and gray. So it simplifies the scene, and the farther the elements are away, the farther the trees are from the camera, the lighter they appear or the less details there are. And let's look at the processing I did. It wasn't too much, so I added some darkening contrasts, enhancing the color contrast especially, made the fog a little more bluish to better contrast this reddish tone here in the foreground. But just looking and analyzing the scene, let's zoom in a bit, you can see that this tree here, the foreground, it was just a few meters away from the camera. There's already some soft fog in front of it, so making it a little softer than it would appear if there was no fog at all. And then the farther away we go, this tree already, it's a little lighter, this one even less detailed, and here to the background, the contrast is diminished very much, and at some point you don't see the trees anymore, there's just the grayish fog. So something like this we can possibly create in post-processing, and this will be part of what I'm gonna show you in this tutorial. It's a little on the edge if you're a purist when it comes to post-processing. It might not be the right technique for you because it goes a little beyond of what you really photographed. So it still tries to recreate an atmosphere, but then it pushes it a little further. And it's also a technique I don't do much often. So most of the time I just try to recreate the atmosphere that I experienced. But from time to time, I just like to be creative, and this is when I experiment with new techniques, and one of such techniques is what I'm gonna show you now. So first let's compare this image here, this out of camera photo, with another out of camera photo, and this will be the one we're gonna work on. Here on the left side is the photo that I'm gonna show you some techniques on today, and this photo, it also represents a nice scene. We have an alleyway with such characteristic trees here, and you have many layers in this photo, which is similar to what you have on the right side here, where you have
different layers of trees. So in this case, both photos are similar. Yeah, the big difference, obviously, the left side, there's no fork at all. And I know this scene here where I photographed it. A few days earlier, I looked at some photos and webcams from the area. There was thick fog. There's a river leading by just a few meters to the left here. And yeah, if there's fog, if you time it right, then you get a similar scene like on the right side here. So you could totally have this foggy scene. But yeah, I wasn't lucky that morning, but it was still a beautiful scene. And I now try to recreate how this scene could look with fog. And I'm gonna show you what we're gonna learn, or yeah, what I'm gonna show you in this tutorial. I added some fog, I added some mood, and I applied some finishing touches. And now let's compare it to the final photo here on the right side, where we had some real fog. You see that it's a different starting material, but the end result is quite similar. So I was able to recreate this foggy, this dark mood, even though there wasn't fog at all.